Hi, this is Paul Kaiser for GoodLearning.com. Let's talk about the basic selection tools in Paint.net. I have this Wonder Woman image I got off DeviantArt.com. Vinny Tartamella made it. I'm going to show you what happens if I use a paint tool and I have not done any selections. Okay, I can paint anywhere I want on the image. Let's undo that. That's the same with effects. If I try to do the oil painting, let's do that effect. We oil painted over the entire image because we did not have a selection. Undo that. Now, the selection tools, here I'm going to use rectangle select. They let us pick one specific area, click and drag, and then that area is our selection. Now, if I try to use a painting tool on the image, it's only going to work on the pixels I have selected. It's going to leave everything else alone. You see, I'm crossing that line and it's only affecting the selected area. Let's undo that and show that the selection also is there for effects. Artistic, oil painting. Notice the oil painting effect only happened in our selected area. Let's undo that. I'm still going to use the rectangle select tool and try to select one of these pillars here. Notice when I click elsewhere in the image and make a new selection, the original selection goes away. There are a couple things I can do to modify that behavior. Select her face here. If I hold the Control key down, notice that my cursor gets a plus sign next to it. Now if I click and drag, it doesn't get rid of the original selection. It just adds my new selected area to it. That's the Control key. Now if instead I hold the Alt key down, I get a minus sign on my cursor, and when I click and drag, what it's going to do is remove the new selection from what already existed. Now I have a pretty funky selection here. Let's do an effect and see what happens. Maybe do pastel. You see we had rather odd selected area there. Let's undo that. If I want to get rid of my selection, I can simply just click here and I have nothing selected. There are a couple different shape selection tools. Here I have a simple ellipse. It does exactly what you'd expect. It does still hold with the Control key to modify selection, the Alt key to subtract from a selection. I also have the lasso tool. This is more free form. If I want to select maybe her hair, and there's a better way of doing this with some tools I'll show you later, but the point is if I have an irregular shape that I want to try to select, I can try to do that with the lasso select tool here. I'm just trying to select her hair. Let's go around here. Certainly not precise. Again, I'll show you a better way of doing that later. But now I have just her hair selected, and I could, let's do an effect again. Let's do pastel. You can see there we had just her hair selected. Let's undo that. Now another way to undo our selection, let's get rid of our selection, we can go to Edit, we can say Deselect, or we could use Control D. Now we have no selection, and again we're affecting the entire image. Undo that. Now I showed you how you could use the Control key and the Alt key to add or subtract from your selection. I'm going to show you selection mode here to give you a little more precise control. Right now our selection mode by default is in replace. That's what you're in right now. So I have this selection right there. If I change selection mode to add, if I click out over here, it will not get rid of my original selection. It acts like if I had the control key selected down before. If I go to subtract, it's going to act like I had the alt key held down. the new area I choose will be subtracted from the original selection. A little more complicated is intersect. Now I'm going to begin a new selection, but the only thing that's going to be selected is my new area wherever it intersects or overlaps the old area. You see? Only where the two areas overlap will it be selected. Let's Control D to get rid of our selection. I want to get me an original one to start with again. And I'll show you the last part. Invert is another selection mode. When I click and drag here, it's only going to select areas from my new selection area or the old selection area, but not where they overlap. Where the two selected areas overlap, it will be deselected. Let's Control D to deselect. Let's go back into the normal replace mode. The last thing I want to show you about selection tools is here the size, the constraints, I should say, on your selection. We start out with normal, which means I can click and drag, and my selection area is going to be whatever I choose. If instead, Control D, if I choose fixed ratio, I can say here, well, I want a ratio that's 4 to 3, basically. Maybe I want 5 to 3, or let's say 5 by 7. I want it to be the ratio of a 5 by 7 print. Now, if I click and drag, it doesn't matter where I drag my cursor, it's going to restrain my selected area to a 5 by 7 ratio. I could flop that by clicking this arrow. Now it's a 7 by 5. Okay. That helps me constrain and get kind of specific proportions. Control D. Let's change to fixed size. So now it's a very specific size. Let's say we want this to be 400 pixels wide by 300 pixels tall. So it's a specific. When I start to click, it doesn't even let me drag because it already knows I wanted 400 by 300 no matter what. When I drag it around, it just chooses a different area of the image. Now, of course, my selection, I'm just playing now. Any effects only if do that selected area. I hope this helps you make sense of the basic selection tools, and you'll come back later to learn about the magic wand and some more specific powerful selection options.